Hello everyone and welcome to the Pat Summitt Show. The road for an SEC championship for this year's Lady Vols squad is back open again after losing to South Carolina. This group knew that they needed some help from somebody else in the conference to be able to win that regular season championship. And Pat, LSU did you that favor, so I guess it's safe to say the ball is now in this team's court.
Absolutely. And it's ours for the taking, and we've just got to be focused and go move ahead and take care of our business, and hopefully that's going to happen. I think our team has refocused and after the South Carolina game, and obviously we're really trying to do the best we can do every day in practice, and you know, making sure that we're holding this team accountable and that they are getting better daily.
You know, this team, the history is when they get in situations like this, they haven't always produced. If it's a half two win or if it's a half two stretch of games that they have to win. With them knowing that, this is maybe a teaching opportunity that might give them a head of steam going into the tournament.
Oh, I definitely think so. And obviously we're going back to work, and they know that they've got to get better, and they know they've got to be invested in every possession, and that defense and board play is top priority for us, and the ball security, and that's where we have to be mindful as coaches to recognize what we have to do to bring out the best in our kids.
All started out the SEC schedule with a win on the road on New Year's Day at Auburn. And Pat, you would take a look at a 21-point win on the road as a good win, but with Nell Fortner being able to study the game film on South Carolina, you had to be a little more concerned going into the game at Thompson Bowling.
Absolutely. And I thought Nell did a great job. She had her team prepared. Just going into that game, I was concerned because not knowing how we would come back and if we would bounce back after South Carolina. But I thought we had really good focus and overall very pleased with how we closed the game out.
Tennessee with a 21-point win at home as we take a look at the highlights of the Lady Vols victory over the Auburn Tigers. And in the first half, it was kind of a slow start, Pat. You didn't get off to the start that you'd like to see from your team.
And, you know, that becomes a concern for the coaches and hopefully for our team, that we do need to come out of the gates wide open getting into the paint and doing what we have to do.
Pat, how do you close out on three-point shooters when they're shooting from the tee on the basketball court?
Well, you just got to get up in their space, and certainly we have to be mindful of that in each and every game.
Lori Johnson, you saw with the bucket there, she got in foul trouble in the first half, but if you take a look at this highlight sheet, just about every name on this Tennessee squad is listed on this highlight sheet because it was a group effort in the first half.
It really was, and that's a good thing to see. When they share the ball, when they've got great ball movement and player movement and go inside first, and you know, I think right there, just running the floor. I thought we did a pretty good job of that overall.
You inserted Alicia Manning back in the starting lineup for Auburn. She just got 2 points there. How did she play back in the starting lineup?
I thought she played pretty well. She's just a solid player, and she doesn't try to do too much, and really she's got a good pull-up game, so really pleased with her effort.
Saw the layup and the foul there on Simmons. Simmons missed the free throws. Sometimes this team has trouble shooting free throws, don't they, Pat?
Absolutely, and there's no excuse for that. You know, you've got Pratt Pavilion. You can go over there and get in as many shots as you need to get in, and That's got to be a constant priority for us.
Backdoor cut by Chantel Hilliard to lay up. At that time, Tennessee only led by 4, 27-23, but Spaney comes back and hits a big three. She's starting to work herself back into her shot and condition.
Absolutely, Mickey, and I think she's a difference maker. She knocked down the threes from the corners, knock them down on top, and you know, she's really, I think, coming into her own.
At the half, Tennessee led 44-31, and somebody that's not on the stat sheet that gave you a lift in the first half was Brianna Bass when you brought her off of the bench.
One thing about Bree, Mickey, is that she is there every day. She gets in a lot of reps, and you know, she's nothing fancy, but very consistent.
Lori Johnson with a layup with 18:20 to go in the game. It was then a 15-point lead. And then Massengale hit a three that made it up to a 19-point lead. But then Tennessee had one of those little lapses and enabled Auburn to come back a little bit.
They did. They really did. They pushed the ball hard, and right here you see they just attacked the glass. And you know, we've got to step up and take some charges and slow down the action.
They were able to get it down to single digits at 8 points, but then Tennessee just had too many weapons, and one of those is Isabel Harrison that you put into the game in the second half. She gave you the same lift in the second half that Bass did in the first half.
And we needed that. We really did. And at first, you know, I was like, who are we going to put in? And I think that was Coach DeMoss's call right there with Izzy, and a good call.
And Simmons with two layups back-to-back, and Tennessee goes on to win by the final score of 82-61. So that means you beat Auburn in Auburn by 21. You beat Auburn in Thompson Bowling Arena by 21. I would say most people would say that was a 21-point team that's better than the other.
That's good.
That's pretty good.
You got the math, hadn't you?
I know. Here's a look at the Tennessee-Vanderbilt Commodore rematch in Nashville and Music City.
It'll be Clark jumping against Johnson to start things off here at Memorial Gym. Let's see if Tennessee can get off to a good start. Tran dribbles across the key to the left side. They back off of her. She shoots from the free throw line. Johnson came back and blocked it. And Tennessee with a rebound. Massengale up to Johnson for the layup. Good. Lister on the right wing. Down low, Holzer. Shot off the glass against Strickland. It's good by Holzer. Here's Lister. Down low to Clark. Clark puts it up right side. Good. Massengale in front court. Dribbles down. Drops it off down low to Johnson. Follow away five-footer. Good by Johnson. Tran drives baseline. Lays it up. Good. Here's Lister. Drives down the left side. All the way for the layup. Good grief. Massengale penetrates over to Simmons on the left wing. Dribbles inside the three-point line and hits the jumper from about 15 feet. Coleman guarded by Strickland. One dribble over to Holzer. 15-footer by Holzer is good. Lead pass Strickland for the layup and good. Bogey drives right by Williams for the layup. Good. Free throw line Coleman. Coleman down low to Holzer for the layup. Good. Here's a shot by Simmons on the right wing for a three, and she busted. She has 10. Now to Brown, top of the key, guarded by Massengale. To Fogey, left side of the circle. Fogey drives on Simmons, shot off the glass, good. Johnson spins left. 8-foot jumper is good by Johnson. She has 13. Massengale, lead pass up to Johnson. Johnson right side, puts it up, good. Left wing for the jump shot, good by Burdick. Down to Holzer. Back to Lister, right wing for a three-point shot. Good. Bogey working against Simmons. Now picked up by Johnson. Drives down the lane. Goes to Clark. Clark left baseline. Puts it up good. Down to Johnson. Johnson puts it up good. Bogey now drives on Strickland. Shot blocked by Strickland. Gets it back again. Forces it up. Shot clock violation. That time Strickland played some defense. Dribbles right, pulls up for the 18-foot jumper, good. Comes top of the key to Strickland. She lets go a three, got it. It off to Strickland on the cut down the lane for the layup, good. Strickland. Inside Strickland. Strickland can't shoot. Back to Burdick. Top of the key for a three. She got it. Burdick with a three. She has 7. And we're tied. Vanderbilt calls a timeout. DeMass, top of the key. Johnson spins. Follow away 10-footer by Johnson, good. Then it comes to Fogey, three for a three, got it. Massengale dribbles left, goes to Manning. Manning right side off the glass, good. For Fogey. Good. There's ball in the paint. Drive, puts it up, good, and she's fouled. Now back to Strickland for a three, got it. Now, Isabel Harrison comes into the lineup. Dribbles left, hands it off to Strickland. Strickland fires a three-pointer, good. Simmons left wing, pulls up for the jumper, good. Simmons with a two, good. Rebound Clark. Clark out to Lister, lead pass up to Fogey. Fogey right side, puts it up, good. Now And a charging foul on a bucket's going to be called against Massengill of Tennessee. Lobs it or gets it down low to Clark. Clark puts it up and in against Harrison. She's just scoring all she wants to. She has 22. And Tennessee down 13. Here's a three by Simmons. Here's a drive by Lister. Lister scores on a layup. She has 16. Dumps it off right side to Manning. Manning spins, puts it up and under. Holds her good. Vanderbilt breaks a seven-game losing streak to the Lady Vols. With your final score, Vanderbilt 93, Tennessee 79.
It's time now for Ask the Coach, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Now open in West Knoxville.
Pat, this week's Ask the Coach question comes from Jim Thornton, and he wants to know, Brianna Bass seems to have good ball control and knows how to feed her teammates. Will we be seeing more of her during the remaining season?
I think, Bree, there's no doubt that when she's on the floor, she really distributes the ball. She's a very unselfish player, but I think she understands how to push the tempo and just really pleased with her game overall. And I think she's going to continue to get minutes and do what she does best.
Pat, after that 61-60 loss to Kentucky up in Lexington, I know that a lot of people look to that February 13th date, Monday night, here at Thompson Bowling Arena on a rematch. And it's a special night because it's Play for K night, and it's Think Pink, Bleed Orange night, or Live Pink, Bleed Orange night at Thompson Bowling Arena. And I know a big crowd will be on hand for that one.
You can always count on the Lady Vol fans. And we feed off of their energy as well. And I think this team is going to have the focus that they need. And obviously Kentucky, we lost there by 1 point, and we need to take care of business this time around.
Quick comment on Kentucky. Does it bother you anyway at all that they have 8 days off prior to playing Tennessee on Monday night?
Well, you can say that might be an advantage, but it's all about how they handle what they're doing and then what we are doing here at home to get prepared.
All right, get your tickets for Live Pink, Bleed Orange night, Monday night, 7 o'clock tip against the Kentucky Wildcats. We'll have highlights of that game and other games as well next week if you'll join us right here for the Pat Summit Show.